Well, it's great to be with you again, Calvary Chapel family. We're going to continue our series on the attributes of God during this time of devotion. We're going to look at Psalm 139, verses 7 through 12, and I'm going to be looking at the attribute of God, that God is omnipresent. What does it mean that our God is everywhere present? So I'm going to begin now by looking at verses 7 through 12, and then we'll say a few words about God being omnipresent, and then take time to be in prayer to our God who is everywhere present. David says, "Where can I go from your spirit? Or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, behold, you are there. If I take the wings of the dawn, if I dwell in the remotest part of the sea, even there your hand will lead me, and your right hand will lay hold of me. If I say, surely the darkness will overwhelm me, and the light around me will be night, even the darkness is not dark to you, and the night is as bright as the day. Darkness and light are alike to you." Our God is omnipresent. Now, what does that mean? To say that God is omnipresent is to say that He is everywhere present at the same time, completely. Now, conversely, this means there's nowhere in creation where God is not. He's fully present in everything and in every place. It also means that He's entirely present in everything and in every place. And only God is omnipresent in this way. God and God alone is fully present everywhere at the same time. Now, here's the blessing of our God being omnipresent. God is the one and the only one who is intimately involved with sustaining His creation. He's intimately involved in every aspect of our lives. The fact is, we are because He is. And God created us, and He sustains us because He is wholly with us. Not just a part of Him, but all of Him, because God cannot be divided into parts. All of God, all the time, in every place. And that's why David says in verse 7, "Where can I go from your spirit? Or where can I flee from your presence? If I go to heaven, you're there. Sheol, you're there. If I take the wings of the dawn or go to the remotest part of the sea, oh yes, you're even there." And then David adds, "Even darkness is not dark to you, O God." Now, perhaps you're like me. As you read what David has to say there, you begin to notice he's a little unnerved by the idea of God being everywhere. Now, it's one thing for God to be there on your good days, but what about the bad days? What about the days when you do the things you shouldn't do, think about the things you shouldn't think, or say the things you shouldn't say? Oh yes, God, you are even there then. And David is unnerved. But then he begins to process that a little bit. There's a transition. When he begins to think about God always being there, there's hope, because he reflects on God's character, that God's holy, that He's just, that He's righteous, and that He's also all-powerful, and that He's able to, because He's gracious and loving and merciful, transform our character, renew our minds, give us hope for today and strength for tomorrow. And so you see this shift in David from feeling uncomfortable to actually inviting God to examine every area of his life, that God would transform him, that He would renew him, that He would make David to be the man that God wants him to be. And he makes that invitation in the last two verses, verses 23 and 24. He says, "Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my anxious thoughts, and see if there be any hurtful way in me, and lead me in your everlasting way." That was David's prayer. And that should be our prayer too. And I want to pray right now, invite you to join me, that we would make David's prayer our prayer to the omnipresent God. Lord, you know everything, and you are everywhere present in everything. So now, Lord, transform my life. Let's pray. Father, we thank you that you are omnipresent. We come to you in Jesus' name, and we pray just as David did. Search us. See if there be any hurtful way in us, and lead us in your everlasting way, because we want to look more like Jesus, Lord. Please transform our lives. We thank you for being our omnipresent God. We're not afraid of that. We welcome your presence in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. And all of God's people said, Amen. Well, it's been a blessing to spend this time with you. Can't wait to connect again. God bless.